Freedom was the ultimate prize for a gladiator condemned to the arenas of ancient Rome. However, there was one legendary champion who was awarded his liberty not once, but four times, and each time he refused. Known only as Flamma, the gladiator carved his name into the chapters of Roman history one kill at a time. It is most commonly believed that Flamma was formerly a soldier during the First Punic War, captured and enslaved at the age of 17. Syrian by birth, he achieved incredible fame and fortune in an empire known for its disdainful view of non-Romans. His ability to rise to become a celebrated figure is a testament to his extraordinary abilities in the arena. Flamma fought in 34 battles, securing 21 victories, 9 draws, and 4 defeats. Considering the lethal nature of gladiatorial combat, Flamma's record speaks to his skill, strategy, and perhaps even luck that he survived so many duels, many of which would have been to the death. The most common way for a gladiator to earn their freedom was by being awarded a wooden sword called a rudis. This coveted trophy symbolized their release from the obligation to fight. A gladiator would typically be granted the rudis after a distinguished career, which could mean many years of survival in the arena. Upon being set free, a gladiator's legal status was fundamentally altered. They gained legal personhood, which allowed them to own property, participate in commerce, marry according to Roman law, and have legitimate children. And still, Flamma refused it all. His continued combat suggests a level of dedication, bloodthirst for the arena, or perhaps a sense of identity and fame that he felt could not be replicated outside the Colosseum walls. While the exact details of Flamma's death remain unknown, the fact that such a celebrated and skilled gladiator would eventually meet his end in the arena is a testament to the man who became more than a gladiator. He became a legend. But as with many great athletes who sacrificed their bodies and their mortality for the glory of a roaring crowd, those who truly profited made their fortune while seated in the comfortable luxury seats afforded to wealthy owners. Join us as we explore the brutal business behind history's most lethal sport and how it changed the world of professional athletics. Ancient Rome, a civilization of unparalleled advancement and brutal entertainment. Gladiators were not only a significant aspect of Roman leisure, but they also played a crucial role in the economy of an extremely lucrative industry. While many were slaves, condemned criminals, or prisoners of war, others joined voluntarily, drawn by the promise of wealth, glory, or a shot at immortality. Their recruitment and training was a meticulous process, ensuring that the games remained a captivating spectacle for the audience and a profitable venture for their owners. Gladiators were trained in special schools called ludi. The cost of training, feeding, and housing, along with the lavish expenses of hosting games, meant that only the wealthiest of Romans could afford to be owners, with the hopes that they would eventually make a return on their investments. The value of a gladiator could vary widely based on their skill, reputation, and the number of victories achieved. Famous gladiators could become extremely valuable, not just for their performance in the arena, but also as a status symbol for their owner. Bestiarii were a special class of gladiator, rewarded for their skill at fighting dangerous animals in spectacles known as beast hunts. Lions, bears, wolves, wild boars, hippos, and rhinoceros were brought from the farthest reaches of the empire to demonstrate the massive reach of Rome's conquests. The Colosseum was even flooded so that bestiarii could display their bravery against crocodiles and alligators. It all contributed to the unbelievable spectacle of the games that people would come far and wide to see and pay for. Hosting the games was a spectacle of wealth and power. The costs could be enormous, but the political and social rewards outweighed the expense. With a fortune spent on the games, events were designed to appease the public and honor the gods. Victorious sponsors gained political favor and elevated social standing, an invaluable currency in status-obsessed Roman society. Gladiators played a role in reinforcing social hierarchies and the Roman values of bravery, skill in combat, and the honor of a good death. They were both feared and admired by the public. Those who survived their battles could earn immense sums, equivalent to the annual salary of a Roman soldier, and sometimes more for the victors of significant bouts. Income may also have been generated through gate receipts and betting. There was also a trade in gladiators, with the most successful being highly sought after. They could be sold, traded, or leased, generating significant income for their owners. The economic impact of the games was profound, fueling industries and driving demand for hunters, armorers, lodging, food, and even souvenirs for the spectators who traveled far and wide to witness the spectacle. Yet, the cost of human life and the moral implications cast a long shadow over their legacy. Contrary to popular belief, not all battles ended fatally. The decision rested with the sponsor of the games, often swayed by the crowd's favor. Yet the mortality rate was higher than any other sport in history, a grim reminder of the brutality of ancient Rome. As the empire expanded, the cost of the game soared, contributing to the economic strain. The gladiator business, with its immense expenses, played a role in the depleted empire's eventual decline. And as Rome fell, so did the gladiators, their legacy fading into history. The story of Roman gladiators is more than a tale of blood and sand. It's a reflection of the economic forces and the tipping point for the brutal entertainment that can lead to the downfall of a great civilization. As we marvel at the spectacle of the past, let's remember the lessons it holds for the future.